very familiar with, but the way I see it, this is going to become really useful in the future. So we are trying to help you guys in your future work. I think we can wait a few more minutes, maybe more people will join, and then you can start your presentation.
Okay, no problem.
Okay, so just I want everyone to know that the webinar will last probably about 1.5 hours. We will also record the meeting, so you will be able to find the materials on the Huawei Enterprise Community after this webinar. At the end of the webinar, our host will present you 3 questions, and we will invite you to answer them on the Huawei Enterprise Community to for a chance to win a $20 Amazon gift card. And also, everyone is muted because we don't want to interrupt the presentation, but you can use the raise hand option. And Tolga will answer your questions after the presentation ends. If anyone has any questions now, please let us know. If not, we will wait until the end of the meeting. Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, I think I'm having some problem with my computer. Mm-hmm. But I don't know if you heard me before, but I think we can start the presentation.
Okay.
If more people will join in the meantime, we will share the materials with them because the presentation is quite long. So I want you to have enough time to share everything.
Okay, no problem. I can start right now. Let's open my video camera right now, but after the introduction, I will close off it because of network connectivity.
Yes. And I also ask everyone to stop their video sharing if anyone has their video on, because this helps us have a better connection. If not, I will close your video just to be sure. Okay, for now, I think you are the only one who is sharing the video.
Okay. Okay, I will start to introduce myself first. I am Tolga from Turkey. Today, I will give a webinar about Python scripting based on network engineers. Okay. I'm a network engineer. I worked at Huawei for 7 years. During my Huawei experience, I was customer support for 5 years for Turkcell ISP, which is local ISP and has mobile and fixed subscribers. Then 2 months ago, just now, I started in Ishnet company, which is also a local ISP, working for enterprise companies. I have started to study Python 1 year ago for networking side of Python, which is automation. I can do many things in my daily life just in 1 year. That's why I try to teach what I learned in this period. So in this course, what we will see, just a second, okay. In this short webinar, I try to explain Python basics, connecting network devices with Python scripts, and manage the logs that we collect from devices. Because of limited time, I will not go deep, but it will be good start. What is Python and what can you do with Python? The slides almost takes 1 or 1.5 hours. So after the webinar, I will get the questions and I try to explain what I know. And if you check the content of the webinar, we will start with Python introduction. Then I will explain most useful data types for us. After that, we continue with if for conditions and file handling. We will check RE module to manipulate logs. And finally, we will finish our webinar with device connection and log management. First three on four ones are, if you know software development, it will be easier for you. But if you don't know, you can easily learn from internet. But I will explain the basics today. So let's start with Python basics. So what is Python? Python is an interpreted, object-oriented, high-level programming language, and it's open source. In this webinar, I will write some scripts. To run Python, we need to install it first. Because it's a short webinar, I will share the guide to install Python with all of you. And to make life easier, we also use Integrated Development Environment, which is IDE for Python. And we are using PyCharm tool. It's a free tool also. So first, need to install Python on Windows, Mac, or Linux machine and install PyCharm tool. I will paste them in this webinar. So why we need Python for network engineering? We can decrease human mistakes in operations. We can do faster operations and troubleshooting for hundreds of devices with just minutes. We can create our own automation tool for specific expectation. And we can manage logs efficiently. For example, we need to collect only CPU volume of device. The display in Huawei devices, in the display CPU usage output is much longer. But with Python, we can filter only the CPU value that we need. As network engineering, with Python, we can do SSH or Telnet to multiple devices and collect logs. We can make upgrade with scripts. We can make the FTP connections. We can process pre-check and post-check logs and compare both of them. Especially this helped me a lot because in my last job, I made many night operations, upgrades, and I collect pre-check and post-check logs and compare them one by one. And it takes me at 3 or 4 a.m. in the morning, it will be hard. But after Python, I write my own script specific for this purpose. In just seconds, without any mistakes or missing parameters, script gave me an Excel comparison file, and it reduced my workload after that. And my manager asked me to collect all CPU values one time from an MS tool. I cannot collect them. It's almost 200 devices, and it is almost impossible to collect them one by one from 200 devices. With a few line of scripts, I did it easily. So it will be very helpful for me. That's why I'm learning. Still, I'm learning too much things from Python and reduce my workload right now. So let's start with data types. In programming language, data type is an important concept. Variables can store different types of data, and each of types have different features. If you look at Python, we have also many of data types. In daily life for network engineering, we don't use many of them. So in short, this webinar, I will focus on some of the important ones, which is string, integer, list, and dictionary. If we start with string and integer, we could say that string is sequence of characters. String variables hold letters, numbers, space, commas, and any more signs. Here, we write as variable as my string, and equals it, we will bind it to hello world. So it's shown with double quote here. String shows as double quote. And if we print it, we can show the result. In other example here, we create another variable, my string, equals or bind to 23. It is an integer, it's a number. But if we write with double quote 23, it's a string. So we have here two characters, 2 and 3. It's just a character, not a digit or numbers. The difference is string and integer is basically like that. And we have lists. Lists are also variables that store items. They are written inside of square brackets. Inside of it, items divided with commas. If the integer we use double quote. If it is digits, we don't use any double quote. So in this example, there are three values inside this list. Index is started from zero. So if we check devices variable first item zero, output will be router. And second item, which is value one, is switch. And third value will be 20. 20 is integer here. Basically, list is like that with a square bracket and divided with comma. And we have dictionary we will use in the later slides. It defines with curly brackets here in outside. And inside of curly brackets, they have keys with red labeled. Router, switch, and quantity are the keys. And values also here. And they are divided with colon. Router is NE40, switch is S9300, quantity is 5. So here we have three items, item 1, item 2, and item 3. They are also divided with comma. And keys and values divided with colon. If we check if statements, in if condition diagram, firstly, we check the test expression. If it is false, exit from the statement. But if it is true, we will continue with body of if. Then we will finish it and exit. The usage is like that. We will write if and write the condition. And if condition is met, we will do this. We will make the action. In the example, it is more easier. For example, we have three variables, A and B. A is 33 and B is 200. So we say if B is greater than A, and we finish with colon, and print B greater is greater than A. So it matches, and the result is the B is greater than A. If we have a if statement with more than one condition, we will use like that. We start with if condition again. If first condition is not matched, we pass the second condition. But for other condition, we will use elif instead of if. So every time we will write elif condition. If this condition is matched, do this. If this, do this. But at the end, all of the matches are not matched, conditions are not matched, we will use just else and do this. In the example, it's more easier. We have same variables, A and B. If B is greater than, print this function. If elif A and B is same, print this. Otherwise, it else is otherwise actually. Otherwise, these two conditions are not met. Otherwise, print this. In this function, A is greater than B. So the result will be A is greater than B. So this condition will match. And our final statement, for loop. We have actually some other statements, but I will show the most important ones for us right now. We have same diagram here for loop. First, for each item in seconds, check whether the last item reached or not. If answer yes, we will finish the loop and exit the loop. If answer no, continue with body of four and check the last item checked again or not. Until the last item checked, it will return back and create a loop again and again. To use this statement, we have this kind of thing. We start with four variable in iterable, finalize with colon, and then we write the statement of for loop. The loop variable takes on the value of the next element of iterable each time through the loop. I'll explain in the example more easier. Here we have three values in the first list. This is a list because it's with curly square brackets and with comma. Here we have three items, apple, banana, and cherry. So here we create a for loop in first list and with x iterable. So x iterable start from first item zero. So it will start with apple and it will goes to second item with banana and the last item with cherry. And it will write it apple, banana, and cherry. And the first list is items are finished. So the last item is checked. Like here, and it will exit the loop and finish the script. In Python, we have many kind of modules for different purposes. We will use RE module, regex expression module to filter logs. This module has many functions. In this webinar, I will only explain find all and split functions. You can find many of them, all of the functions on the internet. It will be very helpful for us. We will use it to manipulate the logs in our network job. So let's check find all function. First, the usage of find all function, we will write We will import the RE module first in our code. Then we can use any of RE function. Here we use RE.findAll. It means that we call findAll function under RE module. And inside of parentheses, first we write the characters we are looking for. And after comma, we write the string name where we want to check. So in the example, first we import RE module. We create a string as my string variable. I finally went to school at the end of the year. This is our string. And then we write re.findAll function. Inside of parentheses, we are looking for H and E characters under my string variable. So when we check here, we have three HE here, and result will be three of HE. So when you, for example, when you run display CPU value, and we just want to get the CPU value here, we will write CPU value here, and the result will get easily with just a couple of lines. So it is very easy. We have also split function in RE module. Split function will split the string into a list with specific characters. Here in the example, we create a string as my string. It says the rain in Spain. And we say that in my string variable, find all of the I character and divide it. So it will divide from here and here. So the result is the ra and white space and white space spa and finally n. We have three I here, so it will split to four value. We have many of RE functions, so you can check it later. So they have different functionality to use in your work. It will be helpful. And for RE module, we finally have special sections. This is also important part of RE module. Here we have a string including numbers, plus sign, parentheses, and white spaces. And we want to get only the numbers from string. And we use backslash. Here we will use findAll function. And we will check str string. And we must get only the numbers, not the plus signs, white space, or any parentheses. So we will use backslash d. This means only collected digits. It means only collected digits. And results show the only digits 4, 2, 3, 1. It goes like that. In this example, if we add plus after special seconds with backslash d and plus sign, it multiplies the special seconds until conditions not filled. So in this example, it will check until digits finish. From here, we will start. We have 4 and again 4, and we have white space. So white space is not a digit. So the first match is finished, 4, 4. And it will check the second digits, second item. There's white space, there's parentheses. And right now it starts with 2 as a digit, 3 is a digit, 1 is a digit. And another parenthesis, close parenthesis here. So the item will finish here, the condition. So we have 2, 3, 1, and it is go like that. So we will use plus sign to find all of the matched conditions. Now it's time to check the networking part of Python. I will show in PyCharm that I told you before, we should download it to make our life easier. And also, I have ENSP topology. Currently, I'm at home, so I don't have any real device, Huawei device right now. So I will connect three of routers, gigabit Ethernet 000 to Ethernet switch, it's hub, and we will connect to our PC. For this topology, I have some configurations here, and I will share the document how to create the topology in ENSP. ENSP is a very good tool actually. You can make many things in Huawei devices. I like it more than GNS3, so I like ENSP very much. So here we have topology. It's like that. The router has just SSH connection, and there's an IP address in G000 interface. Okay, so here we have six tasks in this webinar. We will start with ping test, so we can ping hundreds of devices with just a couple of lines of code. And we have a SSH connection task with Paramico module. This module used for SSH connection. And we will collect and write to a text. And we have another log connection task, which is Netmico. This is another SSH tool in Python. And we have a configuration change task. We will do this because many of them make swap projects from vendor to vendor, or in the vendor from old device to new device. So it will be painful from Excel one by one, change the IP address, change the configuration. If it is a vendor change, it will be a huge job. But with your code, you can do same thing many times without tired. So it will be very helpful for you. And final tool is collect some information from devices, like we have four text file with four devices display version logs, and we want to collect the version of devices, the software of devices, and the name, host name of the devices. And then we will finish our this webinar. So let's start with ping. When you look at first, it will be more complicated discourse, but if you just study for a couple of weeks or just a month, you can understand what we'll done in here. I will also give these scripts to you, so you can learn, and you can do your own script also. Okay, our first task is make ping test to several devices. So we need some modules to do it. So we will use sub-process module. And to use this module, we will import sub-process module. This module is used for run ping test in Windows OS. And we create two empty lists for output. So one of them is reached IP addresses, and other one is not reached IP addresses. And we have host list with square bracket, as I told you before. It's a list. And we have three IP addresses and google.com. This IP address is a device on the ENSP, so we can ping it. this IP I cannot reach, and I can reach Google. So the output will be these two IP addresses will reach, and this IP address cannot be reached. Okay, so we have a three device, three IP address to ping. So it is better to run for loop because we will do same thing three times, but it's not a good coding. So we will write a code with for under the for loop. So it will make it one time for us. Here, to run all devices one by one, we created for loop. So it will check each item in the host list. Here, in host list, check the items. And this is iterable, and we will use it under the for loop. Then we use call function under subprocess module. Here we will use call function, and we create ping command with IP here, and which binds to percentage of s, and ping with two packets. So each time the program will send two packets to this host. Okay, we sent the ping until here, but we want to check if it is successful or not. So we will write if ping test here is variable is zero, which means it's successful. We will add the IP address of the host list here, IP address to here, and as it means otherwise, if it is cannot reach the IP address, we will add this IP address to not reach. And we will print the reachable IP addresses and not reachable IP address. So here we can run. The first IP is successful. Second, we cannot reach out. And google.com, we can reach. Sorry, we can reach. And the result, we will print it here. This IP address and Google address is reachable, but this IP address is not reachable. So you can do for thousands of devices, if which one of is reachable or not reachable, you can do it very easily. So for beginning, it will be a good script to make your network is reachable or not. So let's check connecting device and collect logs. We will use Paramico module to make the SSH connection to device. So here we will import Paramico module, and we also import time module. This module adds time between the commands. So for example, if you run display current configuration, it will take, I don't know, maybe 5 seconds or 10 seconds or more if you have a core device. But the program will run in the milliseconds. So if you didn't put a delay between the commands, the later later logs will be crashed or overlapped. So we will give time period to wait the program. And we already create two files as command list here and device list. Command list, we have four commands, strict screen length zero temporary to make all configuration run in one time, and display device, display current configuration, and display version. And we have device list text. We have three IP addresses. These interface IP addresses we will enter. So we will collect the data from these three router. So first thing to do after import the modules, we will open the files. we will open command list file and device list file and read it and finally bind it to command list. It's a simple usage all file opening and closing. It will be usages like that. If you want to go deep, you can check the meanings of R. R is read for read split. We already use it. Read function to read the document text or config file or another file. And we will bind it to command list or in the here host list. So when we see command list, we understand that these commands. When we see host variable, we understand these three IP addresses. And then we will enter port number for SSH, it's 22, and username and the password of the devices. We will enter it first. And we will create two lists for output usage later. I will explain. So here we have two for loops. It is nested loop. Here we have one loop and here we have another loop inside of this loop. So this is a nested loop. Loop inside the loop. It's like the movie, the Inception, loop in the loop. So first we create our first loop here. Okay, the structure is like that. We want to get one IP address from here and run these all commands one by one from here. And then the loop is finished. And we go second item and run second loop here and finish them. And after that, we will finally get the third item and we will run these commands. So in the first loop, we will open these IP addresses actually. Here in the host list, that our IP addresses is stored, we create an iterable year IP, and we will write, we will print the IP address. So when program runs, we will understand which IP address is connecting right now. And here we have four functions. This is Paramico function. I will explain the meaning of them. So our first function is to make SSH connection with SSH client function. And we will bind it to con variable. It's a variable we created. We must do this SSH client starts SSH client function to make Paramico works great. And then we will bind con variable with set missing host key policy. You know, when you try to log in a network device with a new terminal at the first time, it will ask for key generate. You will write yes to pass it. But in this program, we will bypass first login key authorization with this function. If we don't write this function, we cannot login device. And as a third, we make the connect information to devices. We will write IP. IP is iterable here, so IP will be in the first loop. It will be this IP address, in the second loop this, and in the third loop it will be this. So it is a variable, changeable variable in the for loop. And we have port, username and password. We already mentioned this information here. They are strict, so constant variables. They don't change in the program. And in this for loop, finally, we create a shell session to login devices with Paramico. It is also mandatory function to make the SSH connection. So for Paramico, make the connection, we have four functions to use. They are all mandatory. Okay, in this loop, we get the IP address of host and make the SSH connection. right now we must run the commands. If we have one command, we can write just one command here, but we have four commands here. So we must create another loop inside this loop. So here we said that in the command list, we opened here. In the command list, check command iterable. So here we create send function. This function is send a command to device. So we will send the commands with send function. And we will write percentage s, and this binds to command in here. So for example, when first time this function starts, it will write screen length 0 temporary and write backslash n. And then in the second loop, it will write display device and slash n, and it will go like that. Slash n we will use here because when we enter the write the command in device, we must push the enter button. In programming in Python, if we write backslash n, it means goes to next line. Next line, so it means and push the enter button actually. So we will write the command, push the enter, and as I told you in the beginning, we must add sleep, we must add time delay between the commands. So we will write time module, we will call sleep function, so and 3 seconds. So after we run the command, program waits until 3 seconds, then continue. And then we here with receive function, we will give the maximum character allowance in output. For example, if you write 10 here, it shows only 10 character of the locks. For example, if you write display device, it's only show the very small part, just the 10 characters of the code. So we'll make it the very high to avoid the problems. It's not mandatory, but we should do it because our locks are huge. So default is not enough for us. And for the Paramico connection side, lastly, we will use decode function. It will decode the result to simple text, to human readable text, I mean. And it is also not mandatory, but if we didn't do it, we cannot understand the output of the function. So we will use it also. It's almost one mandatory, I can say. The Paramico part is finished. So we collect the logs from each device one by one. And now it is time to print it. And here we had extend the list with new logs. We create a list and extend the list in the new log. And finally, we will create a text file with the device IP address. The format is like that. We will write IP address here, this IP address, and we will write the logs to that IP address. So it will be longer. It's a little bit long and maybe a little bit confused if you don't have any software background, but I also have no software background last year, just very small understand in software development. But after 1 month or with very hard working, hard studying by myself actually, I didn't get any chance to get any course. I can do many things right now, so you can also do. Here we run the module. So right now it's connecting, try to connect first device. We have four commands here, so it will start from beginning. Okay, now it's tried to connect the second device. And the last device. Now process is finished. We collect four commands in three device. It's very quick actually. If you do it in 100 device, it takes some time, but no engineering here. Just program do it everything. And here we have three text files right now. Here we can check. First, make the SSH connection locked, and we run screen length 0 temporary, and display device, then display current configuration, and display version, final display version. So, four commands run in this script. Okay, Parameco module is like that. Now I will continue with Netmiko module, which is also SSH connection. Now we will import Netmiko module with import Netmiko, but many modules has too much functions, but many of them we don't use, so sometimes we just call the function from module to reduce the overload of the program. These programs are not overloaded, but for software engineering, it is mandatory. Here, we import Netmiko function from Netmiko module. This is module name from Netmiko module, import Netmiko function. And for Netmiko module, we use also logging module to log the files. And here we have two functions. First one, we will write basic config function to collect the logs and write it to here. And then we also get a logger function to collect logs from Netmiko module. Then we will enter the host information. This for information is mandatory, otherwise the program will not run. So here we have IP address. This is ENSP router 1 IP address. We enter username and password. Here we use host as dictionary because it is curly brackets and we have keys and values divided with colon and with comma, with the items divided with comma. And the global delay factor, this is a time delay that we check in Parameco module. So with each command, we have 0.1 second. We can make it higher. Okay, now we make the Netmiko function to connect host dictionary. Netmiko function to host dictionary. And then we will create a list, another list, to run the commands. Interface ETH trunk 1 and description test. What we want to do is we create a new interface of ETH trunk 1 and make the description as test. As we check this IP address in ENSP, display current configuration interface gigabit 0. Sorry, ETH trunk 1. Display interface brief Currently, there is no ETH Trunk One interface, so we will create it with the Python script. And after the commands, we will write the print which device is connecting right now. We will use one device here, but you can use many of them like we did before. And we will send command with send config set and with delay factor with 0.5 seconds. We can use delay factor here, also we can use in here. And then finally, the connection and logging is finished. Logging will be done here. This is a different usage of NetMiko module. And after the connection is finished, we will close the session with disconnect function and print the output. So if we run this module, try to connect router one. Okay, here it automatic, sorry. Here we have device type as Huawei. So we must, this is a mandatory for NetMiko. So it will understand how to make action in Huawei device. You can write Cisco or Nokia, it will work different way. So it automatically enters system view. Because it's a Huawei device, and then run our configurations like interface ETH trunk one, description test, and also after it's finished, it will run return command and goes to user view. So it is much more clever, do some things for you also. Let's check it. Here, right now, there's ETH trunk one. If we check ETH trunk one interface, we have description as test. So the verify is okay right now, description as test, and create ETH trunk one. NetMiko module is like that. It is much more simpler, but I personally like Paramiko module because it will be, you can make many things and more flexible for advanced usage. For basic usage, NetMiko is easier, but if you want to get deep, you must learn Paramiko. Okay, we have two modules, NetMiko and Paramiko. You can use any of such connection there. Now, we will continue with our fourth task, which is just delete the output here. We have configuration change. This is used for swap projects. Many of them, I think, make swaps, so it will be helpful. So I will explain the basic of a swap of the configuration file. In this example, we have a configuration file, just small part I collected. So we have interface gigabit Ethernet 000 and description test. And we have user interface console 0, authentication mode as password. We have two tasks to do in this configuration. We will replace the authentication mode from password to AAA. And we will remove description test under the gigabit Ethernet 000. So we have two tasks here. First, we open config.txt here file and bind it to old config. And then we will read the old config with read function and bind it to X. This is a usage of file handling, open a file. This is the use. So you can check with open, what is with open or else, you can like that. It is the usage. So in X parameter, we have the this config file. Now we can replace it. In the first letter, so in the first variable, we bind this variable to x. So we will change it. We will use a replace function, and this is the old command. This is the new command. The usage is like that. Change the first string with the second string, and authentication mode will change to AAA. In the second function, we want to delete the description line with using replace function again. Here, the old command we have and the new command we have here. So there is nothing here. So empty string, there is no character. So it means it will delete the this command here. And finally, we create with open function, we create output text and we will write it as new config, and we will write the x variable that we changed here to new config. So if we run the configuration, it process in just seconds. So our config, old configuration here, we have description and authentication mode as password. And here, there is no description. It is deleted. And authentication mode is AAA. So it is successful. For swap project, you can use or you can modify it by your requirement. So it will be easier for you. Okay, for the final two part of that webinar. Now we have one device with display version command output. From here, we want to collect device name. Just show it. From here, we have device name as router one, and device model AR200, and the version V2R3C0. So we want to collect these three information from this log. So first, we import array module again to manipulate the logs, and we create three empty lists to collect switch name, device model, and software version at the end. So first, we must open the text file as we did it in last task. We open r1.txt file. You can use any log file also here or config file. It's not important. The program will open it. We open that txt file and read it as x variable. So in the x variable, we have these strings. And then we can use array module find function to find the characters in x. So here we want to get this information, right? So actually this information under the square brackets, we want to collect router one. So device name shown between square brackets. So here we will write square bracket, but square bracket is another meaning in find all function. So we want to get just the character of signature or character of square bracket. So we will use backslash square bracket is character of that sign. And at the end, we will use again same backslash and square bracket. And here, we want to get router one. So in router one, we have letters, sign, and digits. So any of character we must collect. So to collect under the parentheses, we will write dot and star, which means collect anything between under this condition. These are this is a special sections in RE model that I told you before. They have 10 of spell sections in RE model. You can check from internet which one is used for which purposes. They are very important to do make the log management in networking side. Okay, here we find the router one, and with append function we will add the name to switch name variable here, which is router one right now, and bind it to switch name. So if we print switch name, we will see router one. For model and version, we will do same thing, but here for model, we can say that if you see version 5.130 white space and parentheses, collect the digits and numbers until the white space. We will say that to program. So we will write version 5.130 white space, and there is parentheses. Parentheses means different thing in that function. So we will write character as a parenthesis with backslash before the parenthesis, and then we will find backslash the small w with plus. Small w means find the matches with numbers, sorry, digits, letters, and underscore. So, and we write plus. So it, until this match is finished, it will collect all the matches here. So it start with A. A is letter. R is letter. 200 is digits. But after that, we have white space. So the match is finished here. So we collect AR200 correctly, and we will bind it to device model here. For the version, here we will do like that. We said program that if something start with capital the top capital V Y and finish with parentheses, find the letters under that condition. So here we write V and small w with backslash, collect digits and numbers with plus sign until this condition finished. And then we set that until parentheses. So we use backslash parentheses here. And we get the version of V2, R3, C0. And we will bind it to software version. If we run this script, okay, we have router 1, AR200, and V2R3, C00. We collect any logs from this device. Maybe we have BGP peers here. We just want the total BGP peers or OSPF peers or CPU value. When you run CPU value like here, we can write display CPU usage. This is disabled, I think. I don't know. For example, display interface brief command. Here we have too many interfaces, but we just want to get the up interfaces here. So we try to find these up letters lines. So we collect this and these interfaces. So it is much more flexible. You can do anything, any logs you can collect with this script. And finally, we have four routers. But right now, this is also same task as last task. We have display version, find router name, module, device module, and software version, but for four devices right now. So here we make, it is almost similar, but some things we will change. And finally, we collect these informations like here for four devices and write it to Excel file. So to make the logs to write to Excel file, we must use Pandas module. And in the Pandas module, it's a big module, but we want to use just data frame function. So from Pandas module, we will import data frame. And then the different thing is we create host list. Normally we have host one host before, but right now we have four hosts. We will write the list here. And now we create a loop. Normally we write this information without loop, but right now because of we have four devices, we create for loop. So for I, it's variable in host list here. Every time we solve I in the logs, we will get this information, this and this item one by one. So we said open I as switches here. I is the R1 text for the first loop, for the second loop R2, and it is goes like that. And collect the informations as I explained in the last task, and print them. And finally, we want to make an Excel file with all of them. After the loop finished, we use data frame function to create file and add switch name, device model, and software version as a list here, as a dictionary. We have dictionary here. Device name as switch name, which is we bind it here, and device model is in here, and software version is here. These are the keys, and these are the values that we collect. And we will write it to Excel file as a result function. If I check, there's no result function. Okay. Okay, program is finished. We will see that as Excel file is like that. We check again. Okay, now it's created result Excel file. So here we enter the keys, device name, device model, and software version. And we got four devices, router name, device model, and software version very easily. Just a couple of seconds, we collect it. And the script is only 23 lines, so it is very easy. You can do it for many devices. And it will be very helpful for your daily life, actually, in the future. It will be very helpful. The tasks are finished, and the webinar of this part is finished. And I will explain two things lastly. In a pandemic period, I created Python for networking engineers with 12 networking scripts in the real life works in Udemy, and I have 5,000 students right now with 4.8 stars of 5-star. Course takes 4 hours, and I explain all of the things that explain here, but very deeply. So if you get it, you can understand many things there. And I have too much good homeworks and tested in real life scripts. After I see that many network engineers are excited and interested in Python scripting, That's why I give this webinar today also. If you are more interested in Python from basic to advanced, you can get it. Also, this week I will create another. I created another Udemy course. After script, because after script, I also focused on Ansible automation tool, which is written by Python and it's freeware. It's more easier to run scripts according to Python. It's very useful to configuration and troubleshooting for network engineers. As I say, it will release this week. Currently, I have 30 free vouchers for only 30 days right now. But meeting is very high, 900 people in the meeting right now. Because of Udemy's limitation, I only give 30 free vouchers for only 30 days. But if you send me email from, this is my personal email, I will make a list and I will, in 2 months or 3 months, I will give the all of them the free voucher. If you join, if you want to join, you can write to me directly or from LinkedIn, my LinkedIn page. My name is Tolga Koca. You can find it, or you can mail me from my personal email address, or you can write from Huawei forum. I also be online there, so you can write to me from PM. Thank you for short this webinar. You can ask any questions if you have. I try to explain what I learned in this period. So if any questions, I can get it. Elena?
Yes, I'm here. Yeah, you.
Hello, Tolga.
Hello, we can hear you.
Yeah, hello. Yeah. So actually, I would like to know what the platform that we are using, or that's any software that we are using for writing the script in this Python.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Sorry. In the beginning of webinar, I said that. Just a second. We can use just our PC to run the commands, but we have a good tool, PyCharm. It's freeware tool. You can download from its official website. You can download and run it. This is this tool, PyCharm. I use it for Python scripting. It's so free, you can use it easily.
Okay.
We have another question from Aniket Kumar.
Yes, for Huawei, which library is useful, NetMiko or
Paramiko? Okay. NetMiko is very useful tool. Both of them are useful, but I personally prefer Paramiko, because in NetMiko you have limited things to do. So program will do everything, many, many things for you. In the beginning, it is easier, because you don't think too much thing. You don't think too much stuff to do, but Paramiko is very advanced. You can do many things in Paramiko. I prefer that module, but you can use also NetMiko module. They are also good.
Okay.
One more question from Abderrahman.
Yes, I see. If you could, from your experience, just list for us the numbers of the modules that we can use frequently as a network engineer, because I see that we use many of modules, like RE, like another module. So what is the most important module that we can use during the network? And from where we can get a reference? To know the exact what module do exactly.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Firstly, in Python, there are tons of modules for software engineers. We have this very small part of Python for our networking job. We have most important things is for us connecting a device with Python. So we must know Parameco module and NetMeco module, or just one of them is enough maybe. But you must 100% must learn that module. And we have RE module, because we must also learn RE module, because if you want to make some log manipulation, like for example, you connect the device and run display interface brief command, it's okay for you. But for advanced engineering part, if you want to collect the down interfaces, you must manipulate the logs. So to manipulate that logs, we are using RE module. So RE module, I suggest to learn all of the functions of RE module and the Parameco module, and both of them is the most higher ones. And if you learn both of them very well, you can do many things for your work. For example, for this Pandas module, it's for Excel, to create an Excel, but just with a couple of lines, you can do it. But it's not a mandatory, but if you do it your daily work, you must learn RE module and Parameco module. And you can use GitHub. You already know it, I think. You can use GitHub to collect the to check the module inside, or you can write Python RE module documentation. Okay. Here RE module documentation, but it is actually advanced. If you there is no good examples for the beginners, so you can find everything here, but maybe you cannot understand, or you just write Python RE module examples, or if you want to write RE module split, you can write it. You can find some GitHub or another website explanations of it, so you can use it easily. Any questions?
Yes. User Walter Smart.
Okay. Yeah, good morning, sir.
Hey.
Good morning.
Hi.
Hello.
Morning.
Yes, I want to ask, Tsonga, what are the challenges you had when learning this Python for networking? And also, I want to ask, can this Python configuration, can it be used for IP version 6?
The voice is not clear, sorry. For what usage you ask, I didn't understand.
Can you please repeat the question, because we couldn't understand very clearly.
Okay, I want to ask, what challenges did you have when learning the Python, this Python language for networking? And also, can this Python be also be used for IP version 6?
Yeah, you can use Python for anything, for networking, for IP version 4, IP version 5, 6. It's not important because Python don't know what you do, or you do, or any network configuration or not. You just write what you want to do. You will write, and program will run it, so you can make the configuration for IP version 6 or for it's not important for the Python side. You will decide it.
Do you have other question?
Yeah, I also asked, what challenges did he have when learning Python? The challenges he had on the way while learning.
Sorry, I really don't understand what you asked. Sorry.
Did you say challenges? I'm not sure.
Yeah. Challenges you have.
Okay.
Sorry, the sound is not very clear. That's why.
Yes. Sorry. Okay. Last year I started. Actually, I was in Huawei, and we have offline training. I say training, but actually, they just give homeworks every week, and we are by own ourselves. So I will search from Google everything. I didn't get any course or documentation from anyone. I just collected from GitHub and the other websites. In the beginning, in the zero point of software engineering, it is hard to understand why we use for, why we will do this, what is variable, what is string, what is list. It will be hardful for you to understand. But I just know the basics of softwareing. So in the beginning, I always stuck because I don't understand the homework. I don't understand what to do, and I don't know how to search in Google. But for 1 month after work, every day, almost every day, I study for it. But and finally, after 1 month, I understand what this code says. I couldn't write the code still, but I can understand what they are doing in this script or what is the meaning of this function. I will understand. I work as very hard for one month, and after that I understand many things, and slowly for my daily work I learn something, and still I am learning. So in the beginning it will be harder because it's a new area for many of us, I think, because we are in always work in network part, I think, as like me. But if you work hard with GitHub and online course, maybe Udemy, I don't know. But you must always be alone, because even you get the best course online or on the real class, you must check, you must write it by yourself. I hope it will be helpful for you, because it's a very short webinar. I cannot explain everything in 1 hour for Python or even our site, but I try my best. I can go quickly, very quick for the beginning parts to finish the webinar in the time of period.
Maybe we will have another one at some point if people want to keep learning.
Yeah, no problem. yeah, we can.
I see we have many questions. User believe. Hello.
Hello, Elena.
Sasha speaking. Hello.
Thank
you. Okay.
Get me free for the audio. Two questions. One is directed to Elena. It would be great if you can share me to all of us, of course, the link to the video.
We will share the video and the presentation on the Huawei Enterprise community.
Okay.
That's we are hosting all these webinars, and we invite you all to join us there if you haven't already registered.
Okay.
Have you heard about the community before?
Yeah, I'm. It's the support forum.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
That's where we will post the materials after the webinar.
Okay. Can you just share a link, please?
Yes.
Okay. Thanks. And the second question to.
Yes, to me.
Tolga. Hi, Tolga. Yeah.
Tolga.
thank you for the presentation. And first of all, I already made some experience with Ansible. And the experience that I made is also that not all switches from Huawei are supporting Ansible. let's say it's not possible to log in the S series, as example. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now I saw you did it with Python without any big problems to routers. Is it also possible over Python to log in with SSH? Because I found a workaround. I found a playbook from another vendor, what is also do it possible to log in S series, but official answer from Huawei is it's not supported in S series.
Yeah, actually there are too many devices, especially Cisco ACI or any Cisco device you can. But for Huawei, I think only CE device, Cloud Engine. Yes, only Cloud Engine switches. You can log in Ansible documentation as I check.
Yes, this is.
But
this
is yes. But there is CLI command. I don't know. Did you use?
I tried, but it's not possible to skip the SSH key prompt. You know, I found some workaround. You can use Fortinet playbook for login, and it works also for Huawei. So, but. Did you know any other?
So for Ansible, I didn't try, but I think it was working for CLI command. But you said it is not working. But you can use Python. You can
Python with it is possible. Okay.
Yeah. Python, you can make SSH telnet FTP. You can do any of thing with Paramicom.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. You can focus on that. Ansible is good, but. For Huawei, not supported well, but I think it will in their Huawei official site. They said it will be increased for many playbooks, but currently just CE data center class service devices.
Yeah, I'm waiting over.
Yeah, I hope also
1.5 years. Yeah. so we will hopefully it will come. Yes, thank you,
Yes,
thank you, Elena. That's all from my side. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Sonia?
Yes, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Hello. I'm sorry, but I have a question. It's not clear for me how to achieve the connection between the network we have on ENSP and the program we write in Python, how we do the connections. Maybe I didn't catch it. Thank you for the explanation.
Okay. Okay, because I am at home, so I don't have any real device to test. So I will create an ENSP lab here. Mm-hmm. I have three routers.
Yes.
And I connect it to a cloud, which is my real IP. This is my public IP address. I can reach to ENSP. So if I ping from my PC to ENSP devices, these routers, I can ping. So physically, I can reach the routers from my PC. Now, I installed Python code to my PC and write the connection like I show. So here, for SSH connection, we have functions. And I, in my device, I will run it and it will go to other device. So if you, for example, if you make SSH test.IP address here, you will go this IP address with test user with SSH. Here in the command prompt, you write like that to make SSH connection from your device to routers or switches. But in Python, we must write these functions to do this operation. After these operations is same with this command in Windows. I can say like that.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Okay, we still have some questions, I see. Can you still take questions, because I'm not sure if you have time or not?
No, I have time right now, no problem.
Okay. Yasir Imran, hello, we can hear you.
Hello. Hi. First of all, thank you for your presentation. I'm also a new beginner for Python. I'm trying to understand in a network, if I want to run an auto script, so how we can, after creating this template into the Python, how we can upload into our real network devices, which programs or software, or how we can upload over there and run this script and get our output.
Okay, in the device side, we didn't do anything. So for example, here in the router, I didn't do anything. The router has just IP address and SSH connection. Okay. And in my side, I will do the everything. I will install Python programming language and also PyCharm tool. And as I said that, to make the SSH connection or ping test, for example, in Windows, I will write ping 1.1.1. And the command makes the everything. But in Python, we must create something that the program understand that I write the ping command. So it's like that. So we must first install Python in our Windows or Linux or Mac machine. And that's all. In the router or device, network device side, we didn't do anything. We just sent the commands like SNMP command or ping command, ICMP packets like that, or SSH connection like that.
Okay, so it's mean we don't need to do anything on the devices side, network devices side.
No.
We need to do to install the Python in the same network. So the condition is our that Python PC should be able to ping each of all of these devices. And then it's depend on our template coding, how we are going to achieve our outputs, right?
Yeah. For example, here we collect the logs for Huawei device, right? We are IP addresses here. We have three devices, okay? And then we add another 1.1.1. For example, this is a Cisco device. Nothing changed here. Just we changed the commands prompt. These commands, these are not worked for Cisco. But I can configure it. For example, I will write show version, and I enter the new IP address here, and the program used for Cisco device right now. So it is vendor. There is no vendor independent. So it is independent software. You can do anything, any device, servers or network devices, no problem. In just your PC, you will do it, and the host site, you didn't do anything.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. Ricky Gersbach, hello.
Hi, can you hear me?
Hey.
Thank you very much. My question is really just on your thought methods of having a router with multiple interfaces and sub-interfaces. If you wanted to display the interfaces and kind of like create an Excel sheet with the IP address of that interface, the description, and then actual interface name or number per router, would you go about by creating the first kind of like display current config file, create it all into text files, and then go to your collector type of program and then use that facility to try and work the text file to gather the information for you regarding the interface statistics? Or would you try and write it as one program?
Okay, you want to get sub interfaces IP address,
yeah, so
right?
Correct. So the description of this interface, the sub-interface, the IP address, maybe even if it's in a VPN instance, for example. So like four criteria from an interface, it could possibly be.
Okay. In this task, I just show one command to do it, but you can do many things. For example, the interface G000. Okay, just. Test. Shut down. Okay. For example, and just we have IP address. Okay. You just want to get these interfaces, IP address, and description, or you said VPN instance binding to this IP address. So specifically, we can ask that go this line, this, for example, go this interface and find these characters that you want. You can explain it, but in the beginning, this is also a little bit complicated for some of them maybe, but you can make it more larger. For example, if I show my script, sorry, find my. Okay. Okay. This Python file I created by myself. But for my purpose, as I told in the beginning of slides, in my last job, I did many of software upgrades at nights at 2 or 3 a.m. It will be hard for, and it's open to make mistakes. So I will make it to run with Python. So I will upload. I didn't make the FTP connection, but from the log, I will connect the device, collect the logs, and manipulate them. For example, here there is six commands here. I will collect, what can I say? A package version, patch version, software version, OSPF peers, BGP peers also, and the registered display device registered information, up interfaces. I will collect all of them in the for loop, and this is quite longer than other tasks. I have almost more than 100 lines here, and here I can say I collect device name, software version, up VSI interface, total ARP, MPLS LDP session, VRP master sessions, BFT sessions. These are all commands I run in this slide.
Okay, so then that will go to a text file that you manipulate later.
Yeah, actually, yes. These are the commands, 37 commands I run, and in all of them, I have some parts. For example, for CPU usage, I only get the CPU value of that log. So I have here. This is more advanced actually, but it is very good. I have pre-check log more than 1,000 line. So here, for one time, I collect each of them and write it in the my script, and too much for loop here, and finally I get that. I don't know. I have. The result, yes, and finally it is like that. Same device before upgrade and after upgrade. The version difference, patch version, total ARP. There, it is all right now empty, I think. And it will say if it is same, it's okay. If it is not same, it will say not okay. And I just run the command and check the result, which one is not okay.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And then I will check the device. Then I will connect the device. And you can check also up devices here. So it's very helpful, but it takes much time to learn or how to do it from beginning. But after a couple of months, I did this this tool by myself, actually. From internet, I checked some things. But there's no example for network engineers in the GitHub very well. So that's why I collect all of my learnings in one course in Udemy. That's why I did it, because I was very lonely when I started this part, because software engineering, it's very huge, but for networking it's small.
Well, thank you very much. I'll check it out on Udemy. That's okay. Awesome.
Okay.
I see that questions keep running. I think this is a new topic for many of our participants, so they have a lot of questions. But hello, user Kennedy. Can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
We can hear you, but it's really noisy. I don't know.
It's noisy.
I think now it's better.
Okay, I wanted to consult. I can download the ENSP simulator. Since the last time I checked on Huawei site, it was not there.
Yeah.
So I don't know if it's possible that you can send me a link, then I'll download directly from that link.
Okay. Actually, Huawei will develop a new ENSP tool, which will be not a soft desktop tool. It will be run in a web browser. So they remove from their official site. And in the official site, you cannot find, but on the internet, I find a old version of ENSP, and it is working. So in the forum, I can send it, and also some of guys share it, and I can also share it. No problem. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, Tolga is a member of our forum. You can go to the webinar post. Tolga, if you can go to the slide with the webinar post, please.
Okay.
Because it's already late. And
this one. Okay.
I just want everyone to know that Tolga has prepared three questions for you at the end of this presentation. Mm-hmm. And you have to go to this webinar post on the Huawei Enterprise Forum to answer the questions. This is how
under this under this post, I think, right?
Yes, you can even see the link forum.huawei.com enterprise, and you can just search webinar on Python for network engineers. That's the title of the webinar. There's also a banner on the homepage if you cannot find the post. And you can answer the questions to win, but you can also address your questions there. And Tolga, I'm sure, will take a look and will help you guys out. Yeah. But if the answers take a lot, we don't have that much time. So I hope you can understand. Okay. So yeah. I will, I don't know. We still have three questions left, I see.
Okay, last three questions. If time is okay, I can get three questions.
Yes. Let's try to see if we can still help. Okay. Hello.
Hello.
Okay, we can hear you.
Hello. Hi, Tolga.
Hi.
Your presentation was good. I have a question. If I have 10 test scripts, how to automate that? Means how to create a batch file?
If you have 10
test scripts, if I have 10 test scripts, scripts I have 10.
Yeah, test scripts. Yes.
I want to automate all those 10 scripts by creating a batch file. How to create a batch file?
I didn't do that, but I think there should be a module like, how can I say? You can, I don't know, then there should be a module that run, for example, test.python. This is Python, the extension of Python, and I can make a for loop for this. And for example, we have Python code. If you can create a list and test1.python, test2.python, and create a loop for it and run test Python. But there should be a function and module for that. I didn't use it before, but it should be. The logic is like that, I mean.
Oh, okay, fine. I'll try, thank you.
I get plenty of emails from you. I will share the vouchers for the first 30 ones, and for the other ones I will share next month. Don't worry. So you will get the voucher for Ansible too. I think Elena has disconnected. She's okay. Okay.
Hello, sir.
Hi, Omar.
Hi, sir. Sir, firstly, thanks for this amazing webinar.
Sorry?
Sir, firstly, thanks for this amazing webinar.
Okay. Thank you.
I would like to ask, is there any specific models of router that can support automation, or we can use any model of router?
There are tons of modules, but to speak with router, you must make a SSH connection or Telnet connection or FTP connection. But in Python, there are modules to make this specific requirement. So just a couple of modules you can actually, some of modules you can run SSH, but as I told, Paramico is and Netmico is the most simplest one and most flexible one. Or you can use subprocess module as I used it in Pintex. You can also log in with that, or you can use FTP LIB module also you can use for FTP, but they are more complex and not use for this networking part. You can use it, but it is more complicated. So Netmico and Paramico is enough for the net to speak with the network devices.
Yeah, fine, sir. Sir, I have one request. Sir, can we have segmented routing webinar?
Segment routing, I am also new there, so I think Elena can say anything. I cannot give for that. I just write for Python webinar. Maybe Elena can.
I always invite our forum members to share their feedback and tell us what kind of webinars they are interested in. We even have a dedicated post where we collect feedback on topics that people want to learn about. So I invite you can even write me a private message and tell me the topic you are interested in. I cannot promise we will make it immediately, but I will try to find the host for that specific topic. So you can share your feedback with me and we'll try to cover everything you want to learn.
Yes, ma'am, sure.
Okay, sorry, I also have some issues with my computer, so my connection is a bit unstable. I would like this to be the last question because we don't have much time left. I see someone keeps raising their... Naga Prasad. I think we already covered that question. Do you still have a question for us?
No. It's covered.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. I think you answered the question so far. I think people already know that if they still have questions, they can go to the forum and leave them there, and you'll try to help them, I think. I just want to thank everyone for joining the webinar. Thank you, Torga, for hosting it. This was a new topic, I think.
Yes.
A different topic from what we've covered so far.
Yes.
And from what I've seen, people have many questions because many of them are still beginners like you. So, and I invite everyone to join the Huawei Enterprise community, go to the forum post. And I would also like to invite you to share the three questions. And those of you who will answer correctly have a chance to get a $20 Amazon gift card. Of course, the questions are based on the content Tolga already presented. So,
thank you for everyone to get time almost 2 hours. It will be good for me because it will be a feature of networking will be goes with scripting. So arduous may be dangerous for later. That maybe in the future they will look for software engineers with networking knowledge. So we should especially for young engineers, we should learn software engineers. Currently, no need maybe, but for only specific companies use Python, like big data centers. But in the future, it will be more longer for ISPs or small vendors they will use. So it will be good to start from now. Thank you all for your patience.
Thank you all. And can you please show them again the webinar post so that everyone knows where they can find the questions? Okay, so this is the website.
In the community, in the forums, in the switch section, there is a post name is webinar on Python network for network engineers. And you will share the link here, I think, right?
We will share the questions in the post
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We will also share the link to the materials.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
I will also share some materials and those scripts I run, so you can make it at home easily.
Sure, and if people still have questions on the topic, they can share them under this post. Yes. And
I can try to answer it. Elena, our network connection is not good, I think. Again, she's down. I think all the things and questions answered, I think we can finish the webinar here because she has network outage. I don't know when she comes. And you can find all of the materials that I show in this webinar in that forum. And three questions I prepared for you. They are just basic small questions, maybe some little bit search of on Google, you can find the answers for three questions. We can finish it, I think. Right, Elena? You came again?
Hello, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes, I have some issues with my computer, so it keeps disconnecting and connecting me, and okay. It's not working for me.
No problem.
I don't know what's happening, but...
So I explained the, what we will do in further and three questions to answer.
Yes, they just have to go to the forum, or they will find the three questions there. Mm-hmm. They can leave their comments under the webinar post. And also, if anyone has questions left on this topic, they can leave them on the forum. They can also find the materials after this presentation on the forum. So in case they miss the full presentation, they will be able to find the recording there. Mm-hmm. So don't worry if you haven't been able to join the entire meeting. We will share the presentation. And Tolga is very kind and is willing to answer some more questions if you guys still have any questions.
No problem.
But now that 2 hours have already passed, I think it's time
in
to...
the forum, I can explain, no problem. I think I can explain.
Yeah, I know it's easier when you can share the screen and...
okay, no problem.
But so far you answered all the questions we had. Mm-hmm. So it should be okay. Okay, guys, just go to the Huawei Enterprise Support Community, go to the webinar post Python on network for network engineers, answer the three questions, and also leave your questions there if you still have any questions left. Thank you so much, Tolga. I wanted to thank you for my laptop disconnects me again. I don't know if we see that people are still very interested in this topic in the future, maybe we can discuss hosting a new webinar. Mm-hmm. Why not?
Yes, it's no problem. We can do it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thanks, everyone. I hope everyone is healthy and safe. And we will have a new webinar coming soon at the beginning of August. So stay tuned.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
See you then. Bye-bye.
See you. Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.